Good morning. Hello all. Welcome. We are going to start a new save game. A new game of Vampire. Normal. Let's see. Character progression is faster if I kill people. There's some real good music. It's getting more and more delayed, and I flaked out on getting that fixed. Let's see if my shorts get any better.
12 dreams for the Red Queen under Crown of Stone. 8 voracious beasts born from 8 restless nights. 4 nails piercing the flesh of the sinner. 1 prayer for the summoned, called by this song. 'Tis perhaps the countdown to oblivion for the once proud city of London. 'Tis perchance her inhabitants' last dance alone to face death and pestilence. Confronted by the eerie and unknown, mortals became desperate for answers. A flock's flight makes for an omen, the falling of a star, a dire presage. Turning to priests for interpretation when there was no reason to be found. When religion failed, men turned to science.
Science!
I saw them build such vain cities, crafting machines made for endless war. New questions flourished as old answers withered. What is darkness but lurking sun?
What
is wall but enslaved stone? What is glass but tortured sand? What is song but a call to arms? What is hate but jilted love? What is life but death pending?
Someone sounds like he had his Wheaties shat in.
Death.
My lord. Such pessimism.
Since the apple was plucked from the sacred tree, mortality was believed to be God's punishment. A righteous snare to keep mankind from ascending to the stars.
But we built rocket ships.
They were all so wrong. Death is not a wicked thing, nor some holy retribution. A true punishment would be to never know its sweet kiss. Awaken from the harshness and be born once more.
Oh God. I should have drank that whiskey. That looks delicious. somewhere over there. Excuse me, ma'am. You got a lot of blood in there. Can I have some? Good morning, reactants. Not Mary! Oh, Mary, no! Oh, but Mary, yes, you taste so good.
My sweet brother. What have you done?
No, I just got a bite to eat, that's all.
No! Mary!
What'd you rip?
Hold on! Please, hold on! Oh, God.
Oh, no. Homie, you ended her on, huh?
Mary. No.
No. No. Finish it, drink the rest.
This horror. It's a nightmare. No! Please! Oh, a no. Moment, let me explain!
Ow! Shit. There he is. All's in the air.
These patrols are after me. No! No! Don't shoot!
There's my spread.
This is a nightmare. I need to get out of here. This can't be happening.
Over there!
No! Please! Stop! I mean you no harm! What's going on?
I'm being shot at. They call me a beast.
What have I done? What's all this about?
Has it fled?
Thank you.
Shit! Where'd it go?
Now, I can defend myself.
Tricky bastards!
Kill the thing! Over there! Fuck!
Who are you? Stay back! Sorry.
Don't.
But you left me no choice.
Can I loot you? Loot? No loot.
Who are you? Stupid beast! Sorry.
Please, Spoid! Watch
no,
out!
Please, stop!
No, no, no.
Who are you?
It's one of them vermin!
What do you want?
Oh, ba-da-da-da-da. This music. Bang it! Hi.
I mean you no harm. I need help.
Die, you fucking leech!
Didn't reload.
Listen to me. I can't make any sense of this.
Shut up, beast!
Who are you? What is this all about? What in God's name?
I'll do the rest of the job.
Just leave me.
Ooh.
The sun. It feels like it's burning me to the bone.
It was.
I need to find somewhere to hide.
Oh yeah, there's no jumping in this game.
Let me go!
Ha!
I need to find shelter.
Well, okay, we'll find shelter. Just stop screaming about it.
Is anybody there? What is this place?
No jumping. I have no ups in this game. At least not yet, I think. I mean, they're probably going to give me an ability to.
The place seems now abandoned.
But
I should be as safe
of now,
here.
I can't be no Jordan. What do we got here? It's a picture. Flashback. Yum yums.
Brother, what have you done?
Mary! Mary!
Quite contrary.
Mary, I'm sorry. Whoever did this to us, I will find them.
They will tell me how your garden grows. Ooh, shillings. Fire and sun. Never mind. Oh, cool. Dead body. Ooh, battle of alcohol. Who's getting drunk tonight? I hope this guy. Oh. My lord, needle teeth. Now I can tell the time.
Wait. This one's dressed up fancy. Let's run through his pockets.
Picking the dead's pockets? Are you serious?
I still have rent to pay. He's got no more responsibilities. What's this? Gold watch.
Beautiful it is. We fancy undertakers.
Yeah.
I suppose we are undertakers. Now, give him an eve.
Whee!
That's impossible.
Okay. I gotta watch. Okay, nothing else down here. Let's go upstairs. You know, a few curtains, maybe a rug or two, and this will be a kick-ass place to live. Okay. Oh, 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 oh. Ah! And you just chill there for a second. Oh, you. You asshole game. How you gonna do me dirty like that? Dude. Alright.
Johnny, this one's lost.
All right.
We need to leave. And now!
No. There's time. I can save him.
Ooh.
That's the enemy coming! The orders are to evacuate the hospital!
Yeah, 750k.
Done.
In the state it's in
He'll
now.
Live. And now what? We fight. Killing is a hell of a lot easier than healing.
Huh, one bullet.
No, it never got easy.
Bloody diary. Oh. Bad sleep, Becky coughed all night. And text her if you want the bodies removed. Yeah. Hello, Dustin.
This makes no sense. None of it.
It makes all the sense. What are you talking about? Okay. Give me a second. Hi, Blondie. Oh.
It's a nightmare. That's it.
Ow. I gotta take this boot off. It's helping my foot, but it's killing my knee.
So be it.
Oh. Do it! Do it! Do it! Do it! You know you're gonna live through it! You're a vampire, homie!
Rational thinking only.
I do not condone these actions. I just know that he is a vampire at this point in time. Let's see what happens if I don't push it. Hello, hello, hello? Okay, I gotta do it. It's the only way he can get some sleep. Oh, it's the only way to get the title card. Silly mate! Oh, yeah! Welcome back, sir. How was your rest? Yep. Yeah, maid service is going to have to come.
This
cleaning
is
service
absolute
is going to have to come
madness.
Through and get that.
I've lost touch with the real.
Madness it is. As mad as the moon. Contains blood.
Evolution. Oh. Autophagy. Yay. I got blood magics. Ooh, excuse me. I'm gonna call my blood spear attack the hemoglobin pierce. Alright, it's nighttime. Let's get back out there.
That voice in my head. If I'm not mad, then.
Reach north, bank.
It must belong to the one who made me what I am. I must find him to understand. What I have become.
Okay, there's no door up here. Blood trail.
These people want me dead. I need to leave now.
Here's the leech. Here!
Here! That's my ups. Teleportation.
My head's spinning.
Wait! Come on, you coward!
I cannot enter.
Clever fucking beast.
I'm still in Southwark.
Over there!
I must reach the West End.
Vermin.
Ow!
Die, vermin!
Let us strength I never knew I had.
Look at it! Vicious bugger!
This shouldn't be possible.
Ah, it's a purr!
My sinew, every fiber of my being is a fire.
Your life!
I feel like a child learning the limits of my body.
I bet. Oh yeah, loot skis. Alright, loot. I'll kill you with my teeth!
My strength. My reflexes. I'm not human anymore.
Gotta get all my goodies. Anything in here? No. Okay. Your king and country need you. Join the British ranks and help the brave lads at the front.
My poor sister. If only I had controlled my need for blood.
You didn't
Mary, someone will pay for what happened to you. For what happened to us. It's locked, all right.
Well,
I cannot enter.
Definitely coming back to this. Yes, it tasted like chicken. Oh, wait. Who's in ads and who isn't? I don't know.
The dizziness from the jump. I can now control it. It's locked.
Running speed?
What will London have to say to me?
Here.
I've so many questions unanswered.
Limehouse.
Another corpse. Have the very streets of London become a mausoleum?
Welcome back. And this one tastes like chicken.
The man has been drained of all blood, but I can still smell the scent of it.
Yes, we must hunt.
I follow the scent's trail. Perhaps it will lead me to my assailant. Fresh blood. The smell is so strong.
Aha!
This is a slaughterhouse. It's locked.
Huh. Okay. All righty.
There is no one in sight.
I'm just wondering if it's a, if it's worth trying to go off site.
Where has everyone gone? According to the blood patterns, that's where the victim was attacked. So that must be the killer's trail.
Not enough. Alright. Open door. Let's follow this killer's trail. Whee! Britons working together. Skilled workers in engineering and kindred trades. Enroll today as Worm Munitions Volunteer. Support the men at the front with a plentiful supply of munitions. You will not suffer in wages. Get into the factory line and feed the firing line.
At last, a little life.
Welcome, sir, to the Turquoise Turtle.
You, sir.
Good evening, sir. I wondered if I could ask for your help.
Wow, you look like you need a drink.
Yes. I apologize for my outfit. It's been a long night.
Been there, seen that. Don't worry, things can only get worse.
What's going on around?
What's going on around here? It's like everybody is hiding.
You must be new here. Have you not heard about the murders? Everybody fears the return of the sewer dog.
Bark, bark? Sewer dogs? Crazy ass fucking pizza for breakfast. Let my PlayStation warm it up. Who is the sewer dog?
Who is this sewer dog?
It's the local bogeyman.
Bogeyman.
Convenient answer for every crime that happened for decades.
Oh.
You murdered someone. Blame the sewer dog, eh?
Is it just a fairy tale?
You make it sound like it's a fairy tale.
People will always believe in monsters. It's easier than accepting their own darkness.
Oh.
We can all be monsters.
All right. Anyone entered the bar?
Has anybody entered the bar recently?
Can't say. Sorry. I spent the night making love to that gorgeous bottle, see?
This is important, sir. Are you sure no one has come in here in the last few hours?
I wish I could zoom
in
and out.
I don't know, and I don't care. This is a free country. People still have the right to come and go, don't they?
I'll leave you to your bottle, then.
Bottle.
Whoever he may be, the killer recently entered this bar. Maybe some of the locals saw him.
Not long ago, this...
I hope I live long enough to see them wet boot boys get...
Wet boot?
Hello, sir. Are you all right? Is there any way I can help you?
I don't know. Maybe you could just talk to me.
Maybe you prefer to speak with Tom, then. He's more agreeable talking to strangers.
What's going on?
What's going on around here? Where is everyone?
Too many dead, sir. First the epidemic, and now all these terrible murders.
Murders?
The murders. What can you say about them?
Bodies found in the streets every morning. Drained of blood. It's just horrible. Some say the sewer dog is back.
The sewer dog? What's that?
No one knows. People have always disappeared around these parts.
The ancients say
it's the sewer dog coming out to feed. But now he's killing in the streets.
Epidemic.
What have you heard about the epidemic?
It's a Spanish flu. Yeah. Killed so many last summer. Thought we'd seen the last of it. Dozens dying every week.
Are the authorities doing anything?
Nothing. There are so many quarantine zones in London now. It's gotten really hard to travel across town.
What is this place?
What is this place?
This is Tom's Bar. A turquoise turtle. I'm the barmaid here, Sabrina.
Sabrina,
if you want to know.
Teenage witch. Always open at night?
Are you always open this late at night?
No, it's only since the epidemic started. Tom thought that people may need a safe place to stay.
Yeah, I bet they do. Where is everyone?
You don't seem to have much business. Where is everybody?
Well, most people are sleeping right now. And those that are awake tend to avoid going out. What with the murders and all.
The murder.
I just want to talk. I didn't mean to scare you.
I'm not afraid, sir. It's just I've other customers to take care of.
I only see one customer.
Yes, thank you.
Well, yeah, of course. I mean, I best check on them.
I'll leave then. Thank you.
My God, sir, you look like Jonah's whale just spat you out of hell. Can I get you a drink?
No, thank you. I'm not thirsty.
Well, grab a chair and get some rest. This is going to be another long night.
A long night?
Why is it going to be a long night?
You must be new around here. Don't you know about the murders?
Any leads?
Do the police have any leads on a suspect?
Even before the outbreak, coppers never came round here. We're on our own. People die in these parts all the time, and no one cares.
Tell me more about these murders.
Every morning for the last few weeks, bodies have been found. And those poor sods didn't die of flu.
They died of dysentery.
Where am I? Where is this place?
You're at my bar, sir, the Turquoise Turtle. The last ray of light in this dangerous part of town.
Aren't you scared?
Aren't you scared?
Scared of what? All the bad shit happens out on the foggy streets. And I never go outside.
So you're open all night?
Yep. Every night.
Figured people might need a place to rest in these dark times.
Right.
I'm looking for someone who might have passed through here recently. Wondered if you might help.
It's been quiet tonight. The only other person I've seen went straight up to his room. Thought it was kind of rude, actually.
You mean he's still here?
Well, yeah. Ooh. He paid for the entire week.
Who is this man?
Who is this man? What does he look like?
Well, like a gentleman, I guess. Well-dressed, quite polite.
Vampire!
A professor or something fancy like that. Always writing, reading notes.
How long has he been here?
He rented the room a few days ago and didn't say when he'd leave.
I need to meet this man. I have questions.
Just climb the stairs and knock on the first door. I heard him open his window, so I guess he's still awake. And,
Yes?
No funny business, you hear me? This is a respectable establishment.
I think drink no longer stirs me.
Are they stupid or something?
Yep.
This is no place for you. Prewen has several patrols roaming the area.
They do not pursue me.
But they're looking for vampires, and they're most efficient.
They'll not relent until the killer has been identified.
I have a common objective, but I require...
I think someone is eavesdropping.
Are you certain? You might as well come in, whoever you are.
Slowly, vampire. Who are you?
I mean you no harm.
Saith the vampire. Present yourself.
I need a word.
Bitch, get that crucifix out my face.
Anyone?
Ah! Fuck it, right, man. Turn it off. Thank you.
Oh. Well, that's something I can do for you.
Goddamn, do that shit again and I'll rip your head off. Stink nugget.
And who might you be?
Oh, I was a little late on that one. Oh, excuse me. Dr. Edgar Swansea. You first, sir.
Tell me, who are you?
First, tell me what you want. Then I may tell you.
That's none of your concern.
Sir, you have entered my room in the middle of the night, pale as a corpse and shaking like a tree. So please, indulge me.
Oh, damn.
Something, someone is molesting people. In fact, killing them. Biting them.
The calling card of a vampire. Like you.
Yes, like me.
I've been hunted down in the streets and attacked. I'm a victim here, too.
I believe you.
Then if you are not a vampire, who or what are you?
Dr. Edgar Swansea of the Brotherhood of St. Paul. I am performing an independent investigation here in an attempt to understand precisely what is going on.
What do you know?
What have you uncovered concerning the murders?
It started a few nights ago. Rumors of violent murders. The docks have always been, shall we say, somewhat unsavory.
Of course, unsavory.
But this is different.
How different?
A vampire is at work here. Famished. Reckless. It must be brought to ground, and quickly.
And what exactly is this brotherhood?
Yes.
Sir, if the name is not familiar to you, then we shall discuss it another time.
Fine. Who are you talking to?
I heard another voice, that of a woman. Who were you talking to?
Mary.
Ridiculous. I have no idea what you're talking about.
Something tells me not to trust you.
Then the feeling is mutual.
Help me then.
Then help me find the culprit.
I may. If you'll first tell me why you opened this door.
I followed a trail. The scent of blood from a recent victim. It led me here.
You thought I was your aggressor? That explains a great deal.
Yes.
We're both chasing the same shadow.
Yay! Yes.
A shadow, indeed. Yet I heard his voice in my head. There was a moment I believed I was mad.
Oh, excuse me.
You should let me handle this affair. You've no idea what you're up against.
No. I will find the monster. He is mine.
How will you do any better than I? But then let me ask you this. What are your intentions if you find the killer?
Man answers.
I will at last have the answers to my questions.
Then I can only wish you good hunting. And pray we shall meet again.
Yes, sir.
If Swansea is not my attacker, it means somebody else came here tonight. Someone must know something.
Oh, whoa, you are right down there.
Evening, sir. Can I help you?
I have a few questions for you.
Well, if you must.
I want the truth.
I spoke to Dr. Swansea. He's not the man I'm looking for. Now, I want the truth.
The truth?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
I suspect that someone else was here tonight. And I don't think Tom wants to tell me about it.
I'm just the barmaid here, okay? If Tom says you're the only visitor we had, then you're the only visitor we had.
I can feel your fear, madam. Please tell me what's going on.
I bet Tyra would have a field day with the way they talk. She's like, that's not how we sound. That's not how we sound.
You earlier tonight, and he... Well, I thought he was going to clock someone.
What happened?
What happened tonight?
He was dead drunk, as usual. But my God, his eyes. His face. He must have caught something awful. He shouted and cried. It was terrible.
Why are you so afraid?
I mean, his skin. His hands. I scrubbed every glass and every chair that he touched. God, I hope it's not contagious.
Tell me about him.
Tell me about this William Bishop.
Will was a sailor who worked at the cannon factory before he lost that job. A nice bloke, really. He's never been violent. Until tonight.
Why keep it a secret? Why not tell me about it?
Tom's nothing if not loyal. After Will lost his job, he offered him one here. They used to be good mates. But recently, Will started to get very aggressive.
I see. Thank you for your candor. I'll be sure to talk to Tom.
Yay, hint. Which makes their blood better when I eventually kill them. Like this idiot, he's fatigued. I need to help him. Actually, Tom here has to stay alive. He is a pillar of this community.
Welcome back. Did you find what you were after?
I can't say I have. Are you sure no one else came into your bar before I arrived?
Hey, I told you, you were the only other stranger I've had.
Tom, talk to me about the visit from your old friend William.
Yes,
he used the word of God
tonight,
on him.
But he's not my friend anymore.
How so?
Why lie to me if he is not your friend?
I didn't lie. I said you were my only unannounced customer, and that's the truth.
Oh, okay.
Who is he?
William. Just an old sailor who loves his gin too much. He worked for years at the cannon factory before it closed.
Oh, it closed?
Is he dangerous?
Yeah. Like many drunks, he's all bark and no bite. He can barely stand up most of the time.
All bark, no bite. I think he got some bite. How was he tonight?
How was he tonight? Was he different?
Sicker than usual, perhaps. He whined and mumbled about how mean people were to him and how he'd like to talk to me outside, and then he left when I refused.
Ah, the plot thickens.
I need to find him. It's a matter of urgency.
How urgent?
Do you know where he is?
You could try his boat. It's up by the North Pier. He sleeps there when he's too drunk to get home.
Please describe him to me.
What'd you expect? He's a tall, sick bastard with a bad rash and torn old clothes. William used to be strong. Now he's a mess.
Thank you, Tom.
If you see him, tell him I don't want him back here unless he cleans up his act, okay?
Okay. So I need to go through your establishment. No, I don't. I need to go back out your establishment the correct way.
It's a good thing you can't see me now.
Okay.
I will get to the bottom of this intrigue. What's been done to me? To this city?
Inspect the boots. Oh, there's a hunter.
Thank you.
in here.
Let's head back to the warm fire.
Shut that foolish mouth of yours.
Alright, you have no loot? Okay. And this door is locked, so I have to put that down. Oh.
Ammunition crate. Good.
Oh.
I may need a lot of bullets.
Okay. Medium resistance, high resistance. Okay.
I'll kill it! I'll send you back to the fucking grave!
Oh, I'm using the wrong thing. Ow! More bite. Yes, give me your stuff.
Over there. Fuck, it's fast. Over there, in front of them.
That was easy. Alright, let's examine them and the body. Oh, yay. Nope, not yet. Not yet. All right, let's evolve. Okay, so what do I want? More health, more scammy. Blood, more absorption. This one. Yeah, yeah, that's good. Yum, 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 yum. Yep, I love biting people in this game. Stairs down is blocks. So I gotta go back out this way. Oh! Oh, hello. Maybe I was supposed to go through here. No. Huh. Am I supposed to go this way? No. Oh. Oh, this way. North Dock.
Fresh blood. The whole building reeks of it. The scent is so strong it makes me dizzy.
Oh, lead rod. Try out the parries.
Not again. William, please.
This
stop.
Creature is bedeviled. I must put it down.
Ah, get off me! Try again. Try again. Oh, we're practicing parrying. Ah, no, 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 no. I gotta practice parries. Okay, this is not working. Fighting you! Come on, come on, come on. And more bite! Yeah, that's so much better. I can't
William
parry.
Was an honorable man.
Mr. Hampton, are you in there?
We knew him well, another lost soul, a kindred spirit.
Sir, listen to the sound of my voice. I'm a doctor. You're suffering from shock.
I must return to my flock. They'll stray without me.
Oh.
Remember, hello. Certain Skulls are every bit as resistant as we are.
Who are you? What do you mean by Skull?
Yeah.
You truly are a newborn. I should have realized.
Wait. You are the woman from the bar.
Yes.
Are you...
bar woman.
Like me. Can you help me?
I believe, sir, I already have.
Ma'am. That did not help me.
By George and the Saints, you've solved the mystery of these terrible murders. Patience, good fellows, I've come to offer
help. Hey, Rob,
help.
If you're there, just do you think I'm gonna do it again?
We can leave this awful place.
You know what part's coming up.
William was not the evil man they claimed. He was just taken by the thirst. He needed his drink.
This man requires medical attention. We'll see he gets to the nearest hospital.
No, please.
Yes.
I must tend to my fold. My flock needs me.
Yes. Go with the good Dr. Swansea. He's resourceful, and I'm sure he'll take good care of you.
You'd best come as well. The sun is soon to rise, and you'll need a place to rest.
You're not sure if I'm going to do it again?
I can learn something about what has happened to William. I'll be a step closer to understanding what happened to me.
Fine, I gotta go investigate.
This poor creature can't be my maker. Could it be some subspecies of vampire? I must find a place to analyze the blood.
With a dead Irish priest. Are you sure you're even driving this?
Where are we headed?
We're on our way to the Pembroke Hospital. It's just across the canal. They'll have a bed for poor Mr. Hampton.
William was... What manner of creature was he?
Predator, prey, villain, and victim. Who can say? The important thing is that he's been stopped.
Duly noted. And the woman? What?
Who is she?
What woman?
Oh, don't play me for a fool. You used me to locate that skull. You must know who she is.
And I thought you a gentleman.
Ah.
You shouldn't talk about a lady behind her back. But I will tell you, she values her privacy.
Privacy.
Were London as peaceful as she appears from the middle of the canal? If only that were the reality of the situation.
To be honest, I've always tried to avoid this part of town.
Yeah.
Pembroke Hospital is the last bastion between the rest of London and the epidemic.
The epidemic!
The flu has decimated the East End and the war still rages. Welcome to the front lines of a plague.
This is where you work, Dr. Swansea.
I am the administrator of Pembroke Hospital.
I thought you were here in service of your mysterious order, the Brotherhood of...
Of St. Paul's Stone, yes. But first and foremost, I'm a man of science. A physician, like yourself, Dr. Reed.
How do you know who I am?
No need for modesty. You are Dr. Jonathan Reed, a surgeon of some caliber and renown, if I'm not mistaken. I knew it. I had my suspicions. But when you took the blood sample from the corpse of poor William, I was certain. Dr. Reed, marvelous.
He's getting a fan boner for me.
I attended three of your seminars before the war. I have the utmost admiration for your research. And what a turn of fate. England's most esteemed blood specialist returns to London a vampire.
That word, again, from a so-called man of science.
I understand.
Hi, Raging. How are you?
The role of science is to refute myth, but when myth walks among us... The Brotherhood of St. Paul has dedicated its purpose to their study.
Sitting here without food on because it's killing my knee.
You are right.
Ugh.
Well, then let me be blunt.
Why'd you stop the boat?
Join my staff at Pembroke Hospital.
Can we keep going?
As a physician. I suspect you'll not find a better post of employment to contemplate your predicament.
This is sudden.
This is blackmail.
I was returning home
sickly
mother. But alas, that was before contracting this affliction.
Dr. Reed, take a moment to consider. The post would be for the night shift, providing a good explanation for your absence during daylight hours.
Yeah.
You'll be adequately reimbursed and have a place to hide. I even had the forethought to bring some clean clothes. So, what do you say?
I have no choice.
It seems I have little choice, but yours is a generous offer, so I thank you.
Brilliant! Oh, Jonathan, this is one for the book, and the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Fine, you're gonna watch me undress now. Yay. Pem broke the hospital.
Dr. Swansea, thank goodness. I was beginning to be concerned.
Worry no more, Nurse Crane, for I bring good news.
Yes.
Oh, Doctor, what a night. We lost two more patients. Nurse Scow said she couldn't take it anymore and resigned.
Yes, well, I'll make a new rotor in the morning. In the meantime, find a good bed for Mr. Hampton. Be sure to pay attention to his needs.
Of course, Doctor.
Oh, and Dorothy?
Yes, Doctor?
Dr. Reed here has just returned from the front. He served King and Country.
Yeah.
He'll be joining us here at Pembroke. We're very lucky to have gained a surgeon of his talent, and one so experienced in blood transfusions.
That is good news indeed, Doctor.
Oh, yes.
Yep.
Here at Pembroke, it's not what we have, but what we haven't.
Guide
it's only thanks to Nurse Crane and the staff that our ship doesn't sink. If you have any questions, just ask her.
Duly noted. Thank you.
Your assistance is required, Dr. Swansea, immediately.
Welcome aboard, Jonathan. We'll catch up after my rounds. Coming, Nurse Crane. I'm coming.
Look on my hand, Jesus.
Now, it's my turn.
Rotten or pristine, each heart contains the spirit of life. Drink at this river, dry it all.
Oh, come on, you bastard! I won't bite!
Sir, please! You've lost too much blood. Calm yourself.
You think I didn't notice? Stop your staring and get me to an hospital, you arse!
More polite.
Insulting a good Samaritan. Not exactly the way to get rescued.
All right, sorry. I am in pain here. My guts are spilling out onto the street and you're yabbering on.
Yeah.
Yes. That's a very nasty wound you've got there. Take my word, I was...
I am
a doctor. Dr. Jonathan Reed.
Name's Clay Cox. I'd appreciate you helping me to a better place, Doc.
Follow me, Mr. Cox. Let me assist you to that better place.
You're very strong. Okay. Why do I need to mesmerize Clay? Okay.
Bring this fading light into the shadows. Dance with him the dance of life and death.
Oh. Oh, this is scripted.
No more. Not tonight. Oh. Not like this. I will not take another life.
What happened? Whoa, I feel giddy.
Okay, there.
Did I black out? Whoa.
Oh, okay. Giddy. Stuff like that. Yay!
It is wise for the huntsman to sometimes let his prey go. But no famished hunter can run for long.
Oh, yeah. You stay down there, Mr. Cox.
Doctor, where have you been? I've little time to play hide-and-seek with new staff members, no matter how illustrious they may be.
I found a wounded man by the docks. He answers to the name of Clay Cox. He requires urgent medical attention.
Already making the rounds? That's the Pembroke spirit.
That's right.
I'll ask our porter, Milton, to bring him back immediately.
Thank you, nurse. What can I do for you?
Yeah. Dr. Swansea insisted we provide you a quiet office. You'll find it on the second floor with your name on the door.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Nurse Crane?
Nurse Crane, isn't it?
Yes, Dorothy Crane. Welcome to Pembroke Hospital, Dr. Reed. Your office has been prepared.
Thank you. Let's get some questions.
I would like to ask a few questions first.
Who is Dr. Swansea?
What kind of man is Dr. Swansea?
Well, you accepted the job from him. I thought you would have known about your employer.
Why are you not looking at me? Okay, now you're looking at me. I've only just met him.
Apologies, I've only just met him the once. This is sudden. I've only just returned to England.
Dr. Swansea is a brilliant surgeon and the most compassionate physician.
He knows me more than I know.
It's right to assume Dr. Swansea knows far more about me than I do about him.
Come on.
You'll get to know him soon enough, and better than me. The administrator has better things to do than mix with us.
What? All right, I don't like that, but... How is Mr. Hampton?
And Mr. Hampton, the patient we brought in. How does he fare?
I gave him a sedative to help him sleep. Poor thing was in quite a state of shock.
Yeah, I bet. Where's my room?
If you could point me in the direction of my room again, nurse.
Second floor of the hospital, left after the stairs. It's the last vacant office at the end of the corridor.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Nurse Crane.
You, sir.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
So it is true. The famous Dr. Reed has joined us.
Yep.
I can't think of any better news during these terrible times.
Do we know each other?
Actually, yes. We met once before at the Rockefeller University in New York.
Dr. Tippett's, yes, I remember. I was assisting Professor Carell in his research about coronary bypasses. He had nothing but praise for you.
He was also very confident about your future.
Aww.
And look at you now. Eminent surgeon and blood transfusion specialist.
That's awesome. Yeah, see? Hints required.
What is the Pembroke Hospital situation? And please, speak freely.
This hospital is not exactly the best of London. I'm sure you are used to working in a better environment.
People are more important.
It's more than enough. In any case, the personnel of a hospital are much more important to me than the building.
Don't be misled by appearances, Dr. Reed. This hospital does not lack talented people. It just lacks hope.
Aww. Okay, tell me about the staff.
What can you tell me about the staff in the hospital?
Some are really good, and others are
not so good.
But during this troubled period, there is no time for slander. I prefer to focus on the positive character traits.
That's awesome!
Tell me more about cherished people, then.
Nurse Branigan is a pearl. She is the most helpful and dedicated nurse I've ever worked with. A clever and cheerful woman.
You really seem to admire her skills.
I'll go even further. If she was a man, she would be a damn fine practitioner.
Aside from the time frame that this is set in.
Any opinion about the management?
That's awesome.
I don't always agree with Dr. Swansea's reserve, but I must admit he does all he can to keep this facility running during this crisis.
Ah, yes, the burden of command.
I was fed up with this concept while serving as a medical officer.
Yes.
Don't get me wrong. Swansea's a good administrator. I just wish he would get out of his office down again.
Ooh, well, I'm not gonna do that. I gotta be careful. Personal questions. Nope. Okay, that's all from
Goodbye,
you. Thank
Dr.
you.
Goodbye, Dr. Tippett.
Just an FYI, I will be skipping goodbye things most of the time.
There's no time for self.
Good evening, nurse. I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed, the new surgeon here at the Pembroke.
Dr. Swansea has already told us about you, sir. I'm Nurse Gwyneth Branigan. Welcome to the Pembroke Hospital.
Did he really? It's a good thing I wasn't hoping to keep a low profile.
All uh-huh. members of staff have already read about your new blood transfusion technique.
Yeah.
Dr. Swansea made sure of that.
I see. Well, I'm a little surprised, but I suppose I'll just have to deal with this unexpected notoriety.
You must know, blood transfusions are Dr. Swansea's primary subject of research. He is convinced it is the future.
Ah, cool. You're life in London. What's the situation?
How are things here?
Not good, to say the least. We're struggling against an invisible enemy, more lethal than any bullet from a gun. It's hard, Doctor.
It's not an invisible enemy.
An invisible enemy. Quite a poetic term for a disease, especially from a nurse.
Sorry, Doctor. These last few weeks have been exhausting. We could all do with a good night's sleep.
Yeah. This hospital failed.
Do you think this hospital can survive the epidemic?
We are all volunteers here, and we're trying to hold fast, but how do we beat an invisible killer? Some nurses have already resigned.
I'm not familiar with all the staff yet. Perhaps you could help me.
Brilliant professionals, most of them. Dr. Swansea has a gift for recruiting talent.
Most of them. Is there a problem I should know about, nurse?
It would be inappropriate for me to speak ill of a colleague.
Speak up.
Nurse Branigan, if you do know something, please tell me.
Sorry.
Anything you say will be held in confidence.
No. Yeah. I may disagree with some conduct, but in the end, everybody is doing their best.
All right, anyone that stands out?
Is there anyone that stands out?
Well, I have never met someone as dedicated as Dr. Tippett. He should be a standard for us all here.
Yeah.
If only he were younger.
Why should his age be a problem?
I guess it's fair to say he's always pushing himself to the limit.
Push it to the limit.
He just doesn't know when to stop and get some rest.
Ah. Personal questions. Aha! Tippett praises you.
Why does Dr. Tippett claim you're the main reason he keeps working, despite his fatigue?
If it wasn't for him, I probably would have left the Pembroke years ago.
Oh. Dr. Tippett does not think of you as just a nurse anymore, does he?
If you're suggesting he's not taking my gender into consideration when it comes to medical practice and knowledge, I really hope he doesn't.
Okay.
Goodbye, nurse.
There's like one extra person out here.
Right?
No?
Dr. Swansea is right. This place seems perfect to conduct my research.
Hey, sir.
Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. Reed. I believe we're going to be colleagues.
Yeah. Reed? Yes, I've been informed about your arrival.
Oh.
I'm Waverly Ackroyd. Welcome aboard, Ackroyd. I suppose.
Does my arrival inconvenience you in some way, Dr. Ackroyd?
Let us just say that I don't particularly share Dr. Swansea's enthusiasm for hiring you. What we need here are reliable professionals, not overrated dabblers.
Oh, dabbler. Do you have a problem?
If you have a problem with me, Dr. Ackroyd, please feel free to tell me.
Dr. Swansea has imposed your presence on this hospital without asking anyone's advice. The benefit of his position. But I don't agree with it.
I know we've never met before, but I believe this hospital could use all the help it can get. You will agree with that, I'm sure.
Oh, but I have heard about you, Dr. Reed. Of course, you can't say the same about me.
Yeah.
Since I have not wasted my time courting the press.
Oh my god. No need for such animosity.
There is no need for such animosity between us. Don't you think the epidemic is already enough to deal with?
That is one point we could agree on. And that is precisely why I want to be sure that you will be of help in this hospital instead of a burden.
At the Pembroke.
Since your tenure in this hospital is longer than mine, perhaps you can tell me more about this place.
Let's just say I'm tired of the carelessness around me. I have always respected the skills of Dr. Swansea, but over time his enthusiasm has become displaced.
Carelessness? Exactly what are you talking about?
We're here to save lives. The people who trust us are not volunteering for experimentation. They're here to be healed.
I don't intend to run any radical experiments, Doctor. Even if I, as any good practitioner should, express an interest in pushing the boundaries of medical research.
Modern medical methods were created through audacity and ego. But there are rules in our line of work, and they're here to protect our patients.
All right, dude.
It seems you have bad memories of your military service.
I refuse to see this industrial slaughter as scientific progress. War only reveals the worst in men.
We can at least agree on something, Dr. Aykroyd.
Yeah.
I don't know what you've heard about me, but I have already proved my value as a practitioner.
I don't question
your skills, Dr. Reed, but your motive. Is it money? Fame? Or are you truly dedicated?
And what exactly is that supposed to mean?
I served in the war just like you. But unlike you, I did not use the wounded to play the modern sorcerer.
Be careful what you insinuate, Dr. Aykroyd.
I only want you to admit you used those men to improve your theories.
Knowledge has always been and will remain our main weapon. And it has always come at a price. And personal initiative.
It is not a question of initiative, it is a question of integrity. These men and women have put their faith in us, Dr. Reed.
Oh, okay.
Thank you for your time.
You're good, Dorothy. You.
Good evening, Doctor. I believe we're going to be working together.
Yep,
Dr.
Yep.
Reed. Dr. Swansea informed us of your arrival, but I could not dare to believe we'd have such good fortune. Such an honor, sir.
Jesus, he's tall. He's got to be like 6 foot
five. I am Thoreau Strickland. Dr. Thoreau Strickland. I'm a great admirer of your work, Dr. Reed.
Can no one not notice the veins in his face? Let's start with that one.
Please, could you tell me something about yourself? I'm a great admirer of your work concerning blood transfusion, Dr. Reed. I run my own experiments. I'm convinced it's the future.
Ooh, what made you choose that career?
What made you choose to be a doctor?
I'm not ashamed to admit you and your work have inspired me. I am honored to have the opportunity to work by your side.
I'll be glad to help you.
It's always a pleasure to share scientific and medical knowledge with someone eager to learn. I'll be glad to help you if I can.
This epidemic may be the century's most terrible disaster, but I'm convinced that we, as doctors, are the only ones able to defeat it.
Tell me about your experiment.
I based my technique on my mentor's research. He helped me perfect my method. What is yours?
I'd rather not talk about it. For now, it's just theories and first approach. My process is purely experimental. And unsuccessful.
As long as you're cautious and methodical, you may remain empty-handed.
Ooh. Sit ya. Okay, two more. Oh, the patient. Yay. So, that's good, I guess.
But you won't fail.
You're not the first one to warn me. But I am convinced knowledge is the main weapon against the ravages of this epidemic.
Aykroyd's aversion.
What do you think of Dr. Aykroyd's aversion to modern medical methods?
It's a shame he's so narrow-minded.
Dr. Swansea taught me that science is about exploring uncharted territory. I'm convinced that's true. With the influenza and all that's going on, you should put your differences aside, don't you think? Why is it so difficult to work together?
Yeah.
I believe that if Dr. Aykroyd had been the one to discover the transfusion process, he would be the first to recommend its use.
So you believe it's just a question of jealousy and pride?
Dr. Aykroyd is as proud as he is blinded by his obsolete concept of medical science.
Do you need my medical attention, dear colleague?
You don't have to worry about me, Dr. Reed. I am here to assist you, not to be a burden.
Oh, dude. Okay, so... Okay, let's go back.
What can you tell me about Pembroke?
Well, it has always been an honor to work with Dr. Swansea. But with your arrival, I can't think of a better opportunity to learn about blood transfusion.
You seem quite optimistic. It's a rare and precious attitude in these difficult times.
I'm convinced that this epidemic is a test of endurance and dedication for us men of science.
Questions remain about our capacity to resolve the situation.
True. Last summer, during the first wave of the epidemic, I used to joke with Milton about the extra work.
We're not smiling now. Do you need my help?
Do you need help with anything in particular?
Well, yes, maybe. I'm waiting for a batch of products I ordered for my personal research, yet my supplier seems to have vanished.
Do you want me to play the errand boy for you?
Oh no, Dr. Reed. But if you went personally to his shop, what with your reputation and all, he wouldn't dare to refuse the products I need.
I see. Well, give me the address, for I may pass by if I have time.
Awesome. Personal questions.
Tell me more about your willingness to experiment with new medical techniques.
Harvey Fiddick is a patient suffering from a severe injury that could cripple him if not treated correctly.
Yeah.
I'm convinced your blood transfusion technique could help him.
What is it you really want? To save him or to prove your point?
Fair question. I want nothing but to save my patient, Dr. Reed. Especially since I know Mr. Fiddick's story.
Tell me his story.
Tell me Mr. Fiddick's story.
Our first diagnosis was compromised because Mr. Fiddick lied to us about the real origin of his injury. He first claimed it was an accident.
But why would he hide such crucial information from us?
Because he is a proud father, ashamed of putting his children at risk because of his own negligence.
Oh, no. Must remain neutral.
This personal involvement could also appear to be a lack of impartiality. You must know that a good surgeon must remain neutral.
I agree. But that does not excuse Dr. Aykroyd's behavior, a man who did not even take time to converse with his patient.
Do you think keeping his distance was a mistake?
All I know is that I'm taking care of human beings with desires, hopes, and fears. Not some biological machine comprised of blood, bones, and flesh.
Okay.
Goodbye, Doctor.
And now we talk to you.
Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. Reed. May I help you?
I don't know if a third opinion is needed. Your colleagues are already arguing about my condition.
Yeah.
I see. Would you mind telling me more about your situation?
I'm Harvey Fiddick. All I want is to get me bloody arm fixed properly.
All right. Tell me about yourself.
Tell me about yourself, Mr. Fiddick.
I'm just a regular guy waiting to get his arm fixed so I can return to work and to my family.
I was more curious about what you were doing before being hospitalized.
Yeah. I'm a carpenter, and a good one too. But that means I need both arms to feed my family, Dr. Reed.
Okay, how about this hospital?
Are you satisfied with your treatment here?
Well, it's clear that I've chosen a bad time to be injured. Forgive my bluntness. But you seem overwhelmed by cases of the flu.
I won't lie to you about it. I'm afraid we are.
Are you sure you don't want to operate yourself, Dr. Reed? I have the feeling you're very capable. And your colleagues seem to think so too.
In other circumstances, you would be right. But for now, I don't think I can take on the responsibility. My apologies.
Tell me about the doctors who are arguing about your case.
Strickland and Aykroyd. They both want the best for me, but there's a lot of pride there. Doctors are no different from carpenters, it seems.
Yeah. What do you mean?
I often had professional arguments with rivals on a building site. Difference is, I disagreed about wooden nails, not flesh and bones.
Personal questions, why I feel guilty about it.
Tell me about your injury, Harvey. Why do you feel so guilty about it?
My wife died because of me. And now I may lose everything because I've been careless enough to hurt myself. What an arsehole.
Your wife died?
How could your job be responsible for your wife's death?
I was working a double. She went out to bring me a hot meal and got caught in a German bomb raid.
Oh no.
You can't hold yourself responsible for your injury, Mr. Fiddick. Unless you tried to hurt yourself.
Of course I didn't hurt myself. But I can't work until my arm is fixed. My children need to eat, Doctor.
About, yeah,
tell me more about the death of your wife, Harvey.
1915. I was in the army. Building workshops for the Royal Flying Corps. Ooh. Helen was happy I wasn't sent to the front.
That's good.
What happened?
The Germans sent Zeppelins to bomb the construction site, but they missed their target.
Oh, no.
My wife was bringing my dinner when the bombs fell.
I'm sorry for your loss. So many died during the bombings. I served in France and witnessed the carnage there.
I would like to say that she didn't suffer. Truth is, I have no idea.
That's sad.
I just know that I'm all that my kids have. Poor little bleeders.
Are your children all right?
How are your children after losing their mother?
They were smaller then. The only good thing about this is my Ellen didn't bring them with her that night.
Goodbye for now, Mr. Fiddick. I'll see you later.
Sweet girl. Reads me like a book.
Actually, I want to talk to you, young man.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Reed. Can I help at all?
No.
Really? Why are you here, then?
I don't want to talk. My throat hurts too much.
I suppose that this pain is the reason you're here. Is someone taking care of you?
Yes.
And no?
No.
Could you at least tell me your name, sir?
Mortimer. Mortimer Goswick.
Do you need any help?
I'm afraid I may, sir. I don't mean to be a burden.
I will see you.
How painful is your throat?
How painful is your throat, Mr. Goswick?
So painful, I'd rather not talk at all, Doctor.
I'm sure you realize a doctor and his patient have to communicate, sir. Would it help if I gave you some paper and a pen?
Not really.
I see. Then maybe it's not just your throat that hurts, Mr. Goswick. Perhaps your sore throat is just the consequence of something more hurtful.
Yes, maybe. But I don't want to talk or even write about it now.
Alright.
Tell me about yourself, Mr. Goswick.
I don't want to talk, Doctor.
Alright.
I have to go now, sir.
Good evening, sir. Doctor.
You always knew the words to calm the children. Good evening, madam. Can I help you?
It's my son who needs you, sir.
I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. How can I help your son?
I'm Beatrice Goswick, yep. Mother of Mortimer Goswick.
Okay.
Could you check on him, please, Dr. Reed? I've heard much of your talents as a physician.
Tell me about yourself.
What can you tell me about yourself, Mrs. Goswick?
Not much to say. Just take care of my Mortimer and I'll cover all the expenses. That's all that matters.
Are you that rich?
Are you really that rich? Most of the patients here are of a more humble origin, if I may say so.
Yes. Thanks to my husband. May he rest in peace. I can cover any needed medical expenses.
What are you doing in your life?
May I ask if you have an occupation, Mrs. Goswick?
I'm a teacher by profession. I teach young women who are more ambitious about their futures than their families.
Complaints.
What do you think of your reception here? Any complaints?
I have had the uttermost reservations about this hospital since we arrived. but we had no other choice, considering the state of emergency.
Is there something in particular that's bothering you?
Some of the staff were not especially welcoming. I suspect they're not accustomed to dealing with patients of such social standing.
Tell me about your arrival.
Tell me more about your arrival at the Pembroke Hospital. What gave you such a bad first impression?
The ambulance driver was quite rude, for a start. And that nurse, Miss Hawkins, seems to have quite a dubious attitude.
What do you mean?
She managed to secure a bed for my son, despite the epidemic. It was a relief, but it wasn't cheap.
She charged you?
She charged you for a bed?
Yes, and I paid without question, considering the urgency of the situation.
Butthead!
I share your concern, Mrs. Goswick. Be sure that I'll talk to the people involved.
I don't expect compensation, Dr. Reed. But I'm aware such behavior would not be tolerated in other hospitals.
Okay, jeez, don't get anything at me. Okay, that's all I can do.
Goodbye, Mrs. Goswick.
Any new hints? Oh, qualified. This is not working. Okay. She's always got one hint. Ah, there we go. One hint. One hint. Two hints. Nope, nothing new. Ma'am? You shouldn't be walking around.
Good evening, miss. I'm Dr. Reed, the new surgeon at the Pembroke Hospital. And who are you?
Your name has no meaning to me, mortal. You're nothing but dust blown by the winds of eternity.
I beg your pardon.
What are you begging for, mortal? My clemency? Well, tonight maybe I'm inclined to mercy. You'll never forget the night you met Thelma Howcroft.
You keep calling me mortal. Why is that? And if I'm mortal...
What are you?
Well,
hey, yeah, I know, right?
If you must know, I'm a vampire.
Do you require my services, Miss Howcroft?
I have no need for your medicine, Dr. Reed. Blood is the only drug I need.
You're a vampire.
And why do you believe you're a vampire?
I don't need to believe anything. It is what I am. It is what I feel within this... hollow shell of flesh.
Oh. Just describe how you feel.
Please, describe to me how you feel. What is it like to be a vampire?
I can hear my body crumble from the inside as my flesh cracks and fades. I sense the last pulse of pustulant blood within my drying veins. I need new blood.
Ever heard of Cotard syndrome?
I see. Have you ever heard of Cotard syndrome?
Cotard.
Never.
It's a mental illness discovered by a French neurologist named Jules Cotard. The affected patients are delusional. They believe that they are putrefying, that they are dead, a ghost or a ghoul. Or in your case, a vampire.
Delusional, you say? Oh, sad and petty mortal. You can't even begin to understand the concept of immortality. And you think it is I who am delusional.
I'm assuming you must be a patient here. Am I right, Miss Howcroft?
It's only a cover. To hide from my enemies. I can leave whenever I want. A woman, a spirit, fog, or bat.
Your enemies?
Who are these enemies you mentioned? Can you describe...
Enemies?
I cannot say for sure. But I sense their eyes on me from nearby.
From nearby?
I feel them watching me every time I visit the garden near the morgue.
Okay, we'll take care of you.
The staff here are not your enemy. They're here to help you, to care for you.
I'm not speaking of the doctors in white. I'm speaking of the men and women who hunt me, for I am a vampire.
I see. Don't worry. These people will not find you here. I'll personally make sure they leave you alone.
Thank you, mortal, but do not interfere with them, for you are no match for those that hunt me.
are you really?
Who are you really, Miss Howcroft? I mean, apart from being a vampire.
Is that not enough for you, puny mortal? What do you require? Proof of my powers?
I'm curious to know who you were before becoming a vampire.
No, it was such a long time ago, I don't remember. Centuries of unholy life can have strange effects on one's minds, you see?
All right.
I'll leave you, Mistress of the Dark.
They have disgust on every street corner.
Suck you.
Daily routine.
Good evening, Mr. Hampton. How do you feel?
Dr. Reed, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, Sora, I must apologize for my behavior.
What do you mean?
I was not myself in the factory. Fear and exhaustion made me say awful things to you, I'm afraid.
You remained perfectly nice and polite. A little delirious, perhaps. But who wouldn't be after enduring an abduction?
Thank you, Doctor. That's a relief. Now all I need to do is rest and return to my flock.
Do you know Tom Watts? The bartender from the Turtle. I met him before I found you in the canning factory.
Tom? Yes, of course.
Yes, Tom.
Always the helping hand, good old Tom. Without men like him, corruption and despair would have wiped out the East End long ago.
People are still in despair.
How could it be otherwise? The authorities have left us all to rot in this contagious nightmare. No drugs, no advice, nothing. It's a damn shame.
I know. Corruption.
Who should I avoid in this part of town, then? Any particularly evil figures?
Not really. Most men and women are just doing their best. And it's not my habit to speak ill of people I know, Doctor.
What is the general situation in the East End, Docs?
The situation has always been tough, with a lot of tensions between the gangs and the Dockers' trade union. The Wet Boot Boys are very nervous since they lost their leader.
Who leads the gang now?
Who leads the gang now?
Since Clay Cox went missing, it's his wife Edwina who runs the show.
Went missing?
With the assistance of her minion, Booth Digby.
What?
Has the gang been threatening you?
Ah, no. I have had this nickname for so long, you know, the sad saint of the East End. No one dares to bug a saint, not even criminals.
I don't get it.
How did you end up in William Bishop's den?
I didn't kill Clay and I
received alarming news about
him.
His recent behavior. I went to his place and he refused to let me go.
Why did he abduct you?
Why did he abduct you?
William was an alcoholic. His addiction suddenly changed to blood.
Oh.
I don't know why. Just like a patient I met here, this Miss Hawcroft.
You're a hero.
You dared to enter this awful place alone. You're a hero, Mr. Hampton. Or a fool.
I'm just a man trying to help his friends, Dr. Reed. William Bishop was a conflicted soul, searching for light.
How do you feel?
How do you feel, Mr. Hampton? Medically speaking, I mean.
I feel exhausted. Beyond exhaustion, actually. William drank so much of my blood in his madness. I feel...
empty.
You're in good hands here. Dr. Swansea is well versed in blood transfusion, and I'm sure he'll take the best care of you.
Thank you, sir. I believe all I need is rest, and then I can go back to the people who need me.
What do you do for a living?
What do you do for a living, Mr. Hampton?
Yeah.
I can't help but notice the cross around your neck.
I manage a night asylum for the poor and homeless of the docks, and I try to guide the lost and hesitant on the right path to our Lord.
Oh, are you a priest?
Are you a priest, Mr. Hampton? A deacon, maybe?
Not at all, Doctor. I'm just a man of faith willing to preach the good word.
Oh, why not use your cross against one?
Why didn't you use your cross against William Bishop? To repel him somehow?
That's a very strange question, Doctor. A cross is no magical token, if that's what you were trying to say. Not mine, anyway.
Oh. Made friends since you
Have you made friends since you arrived?
Not really, but I recognize Miss Harriet Jones. I knew her when she lived by the docks. That poor woman had such a miserable life.
You never came to see her here at Pembroke. Receiving visits when sick can be an important part of the healing process, you know. We're not just bodies.
You're preaching to the converted now, Doctor. To be truly honest, I thought she was dead. She left the docks many months ago.
Oh.
Goodbye, Mr. Hampton.
And then there's you.
Good evening, sir. Can I help you?
Unless you're here to fix my face. No. I don't think you can help me.
I'm Dr. Reed. I've recently taken the position of head surgeon here.
Oh, I'm head surgeon.
War injuries, am I right?
You guessed right, Doctor. German shell took my pretty little mug right off. But they still call me Thomas Elwood.
How is your stay with us?
How is your stay with us, Mr. Elwood?
Oh, it's bliss. I just escaped death in the trenches to be surrounded again by the moans of the dying.
Can I ask you precisely why you're a patient here?
It's the pain, sir. The drugs don't work. It just hurts under the scars, if you get my drift.
Can I do anything?
Can I do anything for your pain?
Nurses gave me a bunch of pills. No effect. Told you. It's like the flames are under my skin, burning away.
You have nerve damage.
Who is treating you? Is someone in particular looking after your case?
Nobody since the old and tired doctor spoke to me. Started to think I was forgotten about.
Yeah.
Won't blame you.
You don't seem worried by that.
My face hurts so much more when I smile or cry. I've learned it's easier not to speak. But be assured I'm smiling inside.
Alright. Personal questions. Miss Howcroft's disease.
How close are you to Miss Howcroft? Are you aware that she thinks she is a vampire?
To wait for her next nibble is the best reason to stay here. Every time she approaches my bed, she treats me like something tasty. A normal person.
Aren't you afraid? She may hurt you if the game goes too far.
She's quite harmless, I can assure you. Her head's broken inside, is all. While I'm busted on the outside. But she's still beautiful. Living proof that there's hope for me.
Nice. You let her bite you?
So do you let her bite you? You know that's not sanitary.
And why not? She's only supping a few drops of my blood. And the pain, it's real for once.
She could decide to bite less willing patients.
Then it's another good reason for me to stay here, Doctor.
She is mentally disturbed.
You do realize she's mentally disturbed. It's called the Cotard syndrome.
Cotard.
She truly believes she's a vampire.
In her madness, she never refers to my scars. And frankly, if I could, I'd join her world.
He really
needs
help.
It seems much more fun than the real one.
Where were you stationed, sir? Did you serve for long?
I really don't want to talk about all this shit.
No offense. I was pushing too much.
Yeah.
I served in France myself. I just wanted to know what happened to you.
You were an officer, weren't you? Then I doubt we fought the same war, sir. No offense.
All right, you're like in London. Nope.
Goodbye for now.
Fear and disgust on every street corner. Daily routine.
Oh, she wants to sit down. Let's see if I unlock anything here.
Good evening, Miss Howcroft.
I need blood, Doctor. Warm, rich, vibrant blood.
Tell me, Thelma, why do you feel so attached to Mr. Elwood? Why him?
I'm not sure, Doctor. I think we have a bond of some sort. We've both suffered so much. He's the only mortal I find interesting.
You plan to make him a vampire?
Do you plan to make him a vampire too?
Of course not. How could I inflict my curse on anybody else? I'm not that cruel, Doctor.
Are you romantically involved?
Would you say you and Mr. Elwood are romantically involved?
No. No, Thomas is a delicate soul. Even though he disguises it. But I am not the woman he needs. No, for I am a vampire, Doctor.
I'll leave you.
Okay, just one more pass back at him.
Good evening, Mr.
Evening, Doc.
Okay, nothing there. Nothing there.
Goodbye.
There we go. The pain. Yeah, buddy, I know the pain, the pain. Where? Okay, there's you. You. Hard bitten. Mortimer. I feel like there's someone.
Thelma Howcroft said she was being watched by vampire hunters.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Reed. Always a pleasure to meet a colleague, sir. Especially when he was supposedly dead.
A colleague?
Are you a doctor, too? Not anymore, sir. I used to be Dr. Rakesh Jadhana. Now, I'm just Mr. Jadhana. Pawnbroker and humble guardian of this morgue.
What do you mean, you used to be a doctor?
What?
Was your license revoked?
No, sir. It is just that I like to be precise. I run a little pawn shop while taking care of the dead. But I used to be a real doctor.
Okay.
Do you work here alone?
Yes,
this feels
really easy work,
different.
Sir. All I have to do
I'm
is.
I'm not gonna lie, I played
bodies.
A little bit of this, but
the situation
we're
was very
streaming
different when
this
the main morgue was still open.
There's supposed to be a Milton here. Is there not?
Why do you have to watch these bodies?
Because these poor fellows have no names. We keep them in case someone comes looking for the missing. Sadly, very rarely happens.
Why close the hospital's main morgue?
It was for sanitary reasons after the beginning of the epidemic. Cadavers had to be moved to the nearest mass grave.
Oh. Not afraid of the dead.
Are you afraid or uneasy being surrounded by so many corpses?
Why should I? These bodies are empty vessels. Flesh left to decay.
I could have sworn there was a Milton.
Poof.
He was a black guy who had a relationship with one of the nurses here.
An interesting point of view. And quite an exotic one, too. Most people fear or at least have a respect for dead flesh.
Sir, as a medic during the war, I learned to face my death and the death of others. It's the pain we have to tame, not death itself.
How did you get this job?
After I left the army, I worked as an undertaker down by the docks. A dangerous place with many an unpleasant business.
Milton Hooks.
Milton Hooks helped me get a job here.
Have we met before?
Have we met before?
I don't think so, sir. Why?
When we first talked, you said you were glad to meet me since I was reported dead.
Funny story, sir. Your sister came here a few nights ago. You were missing, and she was looking for your body. She must be very relieved now.
A pawnbroker. I expect you
she
get
is
all
relieved.
Types of people, I guess.
Yes, sir. All kinds
no,
of
God,
people.
No.
For I sell all kind of goods.
Who comes here to trade? Dead bodies?
Who comes here to trade with you? It's very unhygienic, even unsafe.
Milton, yeah. That's the one I'm talking about. He's like...
For the customers?
The ambulance
hospital.
Driver
I'm
or something?
I'm very cautious, sir. I've been a doctor.
Like, I know he's a driver for the
and
hospital.
All my clients are good people.
In fact, I think I only know good people.
What kind of goods do
what
you sell?
What kind of goods?
With the quarantine, it's not always easy to buy things. So I trade. I exchange. Some people sell. Some others buy. I like to help.
All right. You believe in life after death?
Since you're not afraid of dying,
do you believe in life after death, Rakesh?
No. I believe we must do all the good we can while alive. For our time is short, and the obstacles are endless.
Do you think you would enjoy immortality as a concept?
I don't think so. Don't mistake me. I love life, and I'd like to live a long life. But everything has to decay, sir. Even goodwill.
Ah, goodwill won't last?
Do you really believe goodwill cannot last?
As I said, sir, everything decays. If I was to never die...
Yeah.
Goodness, I would be bored or worse. And I like to be helpful, sir.
Quite depressing, wouldn't you say?
Yes.
But the good news is, we'll all die before losing our humanity, sir.
So you're ready to die?
So you're ready to die?
No, I am not. I don't fear death, for I won't see it. What troubles me is the pain my death will inflict to those I know.
You're a wise man, Mr. Chidana.
No, Dr. Reed. I am a foolish man. But I like to think otherwise.
Dude. I love you, man. You're so insightful.
Please show me what you have to sell.
Of course. It's just trinkets and curios, really. But I'm sure they can be useful.
And what do we got? Cody! I got 40 shillings. Opium. 15. I just bought drugs. Yeah, Cody. Time to get rid of this cough. Okay, now that I am doubly sure that Milton exists.
Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. Jesus Jonathan
Reed.
I'm new
Christ,
here.
I've already heard about you, Dr. Reed. Side?
I'm Milton Hooks, the ambulance driver for this shithole of a hospital.
That's quite a blunt introduction, Mr. Hooks.
You can call me Milton. I like to speak my mind, Dr. Reed. Perk of the job. Don't judge me, and I won't judge you.
I'm not sure I understand what you're talking about.
Well, I'm no doctor, but I'm pretty sure a gun can't be used as a surgical instrument.
You have a keen eye. I learned to shoot during the war, and have carried one ever since. Old habits die hard.
No need to explain, Dr. Reed. And if you ever need a better gun,
oh, yeah.
Remember, I
Happy
may have
birthday,
something for you.
Early style. Smuggling weapons.
Are you really smuggling weapons through the hospital?
And why not? I've already been attacked by patients, you know. And by gang members willing to steal my money.
But you're not defending yourself. You're selling guns to civilians.
You
I
keep
get,
people alive your own
I got
way,
it
doctor.
Out the way so I don't I have to worry about it next month. We're already trying to figure out how to build my oldest boy's costume. That's the situation.
How is the situation around here?
You want to hear the situation is all right? It's fucking awful. We lack everything. And it's getting worse every day.
What's your occupation?
So what do you do exactly in this hospital? Apart from smuggling guns, I mean.
I've been an ambulance driver since... too long, I guess. I bring sick people here night and day. It's a dirty job, but I get it done.
Yeah.
Most of the time.
That's the sanitary situation.
Since you're on the front line, how is the sanitary situation in this vicinity?
It's a complete disaster. It's even getting dangerous to enter some streets or buildings. Even the locals attack you.
Oh, wow.
It sounds like things have been a bit rough recently.
What's happened?
Yesterday I got attacked by the patient I was bringing in. I escaped from the hospital's garden, but I lost my wallet when I was running.
Left an infected patient outside the hospital. That's incredibly dangerous.
Go there yourself if you want, but be careful, Doctor. I'd rather not bring your dead body back.
All right. I'm sure.
I'd like to.
Wise choice, Dr. Reed.
Yeah. Ooh, Milton's shotgun. Let's see, codeine, ferrous tartrate, vial. Yeah. All right, for now, for the office, I've talked to everyone.
This must be the place. It's definitely away from prying eyes. Relegated to the shadows. A kingdom of my own.
Oh no, I've been banished to the shadow realm.
At least I won't be sleeping in a coffin.
Oh, nope. as well.
William Bishop's blood is much more unstable than human blood and shows extensive mutation. But this is not what happened to me. I must keep on searching. The sun is about to rise. I can feel it. I'll continue tomorrow night.
I have
so much time now.
Coagulation, 2 seconds, control. Oh, wow, that sounds hurtful. Spring, Shadow Veil. Hard biting. Let's put on into candy. Not enough to do anything. So moving on.
I'm evolving!
If I'm to stay here until my research is complete, I'd better learn to hide my true nature from the mortals. But what about my thirst for blood?
Answer the door, okay.
Hurry now, Doctor.
Yes, Nurse Crane? How can I help you?
I'm so sorry. I know Dr. Swansea wanted you to rest, but we have somewhat of a crisis.
What?
A crisis, you say?
A crisis?
Our supply of antiseptics is nearly depleted. I was hoping there was another box up here, but...
Nothing up here.
Sorry. There's nothing here.
Some of the patients won't last the night without them. Honestly, sir, I'm beside myself.
I may have a solution. In France, during the war, drugs shortage was a daily problem, and we had to use our wits to overcome the shortages.
However do you mean?
Yeah.
If combined correctly, certain household chemical products can be used in a pinch instead. Now, where's the hospital storeroom?
Yeah.
The storeroom? Fat chance. This is the Pembroke, and space is luxury we don't have.
Oh?
Everything used to be stored in the old morgue.
Perhaps I should look there first. Where is this morgue?
It's the large building behind the hospital.
We're gonna get some.
You'll need to go in the back door because it's been sealed off for sanitary reasons. Take this key. It opens a small back entrance at the end of a narrow street.
The abandoned morgue behind the hospital. A small door at the end of a narrow street. On my way then. Thank you, nurse.
Running speed.
Scowl voices in the garden. I should investigate. If they were to find somebody.
Give me your blood. See, it was smart of me. Watery, dirty blood sample. But yeah, it was smart of me to up my stamina. Hey, buddy. Die, just die, just die. I hit X. Whoa! Easy jump. Ow! Oh, give me that help! Heal, heal, heal. Oh, Milton and Pippa. Oh no. I'll have to turn that in later. Oh wait. Gun's not equipped. The way he pulls it out, I'm ready to smack. You must rest in a bed to spend XP and a wall. Look for hideouts. Game, please. Boom, 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 boom. Game, please. Okay. Well, it's nice that the game makes everything shiny. Anything over here? Hello? Hello? I can hear you guys. Don't act like I don't hear you. Well, punks. When I find you, I'm gonna beat you in this club! Ah, yep, I found you. Ow!
Behavior is similar to the infected William Bishop. Must be the same strain. This sickness moves faster than influenza.
Ooh, a cigarette case.
This key will surely grant me access to the basement.
Surely. Stop it! Stop it!
Popular as they are ineffective, but they do contain iron tartrate, and that might prove itself useful.
Okay, watery, rich blood sample. Boys! Oh, wrong one.
These skulls feed from corpses and the husks of animals. They're not after blood.
Die. Thank you. That way. That way. Okay. Oh, yeah. Try to run away. Little punk. I think I figured out a really good combo on them. Swing a couple of times, do it a little stabby stabby with the stake.
It's locked, all right.
What? Blood absorption? Okay. We'll try that. Oh, nothing on the body. Over here. Oh, what the? Get off me! Give me your blood! Shit! What? This is better!
These skulls can be so ferocious.
Yes, they can.
I'm not sure I can defeat them without becoming stronger. To drink blood is so tempting.
All right, let's upgrade shit. Light blood serum. Oh. Oh. Oh wait. The guns. No. Okay, so I'll do that. Add 13 stun. Okay, this one. You know, yeah. And we'll decrease damage consumption. Let's see, damage dealt. Oh, I can't do either. You. Nope. All right. Hey, buddy. Dude, I know you went this way. Yes, I know I need a rest to evolve. Oh, I also need to get out of here. Go talk to Milton. Cause you have some splendid total. I mean, given for the current time period, I guess that kind of relationship was frowned upon. I mean, they are. And are off as dating. Milton Bradley. Milton's Milton, or we make Milton's. Pembroke Hospital. That is helpful. Oh, you guys are cleared out? Cleared out? You guys don't respawn? What's in here? Oh, this is a hospital? No. It's not. Are you still over there? Nope. Managed to make it all go away. Good automatic closing doors. All right, let's go find Milton. Milton.
Good evening, Milton.
Good evening, Doctor. Still trying to save lives.
I have found your wallet.
I have some good news, Milton.
What? The epidemic's over?
I retrieved your wallet. With all the money and a certain picture.
Well, yeah. Pippa Hawkins is my girl. So what? Is it the difference of skin color that bothers you?
Not at all, Milton.
Good. Please, take this money anyway. To remind you to keep your mouth shut.
Oh.
Not everybody is as broad-minded as you, Dr. Reed.
What's your relationship?
What's going on between you and Nurse Hawkins?
Pippa's tired.
The little tired pillows full of molten lava. Yes, they
tired
should be
of
called
all
that. Pizza
up.
Roll's arm.
She's as
lava
depressed
pocket.
As I am.
Bound by despair.
During the war, I witnessed a few couples just like you come together in difficult circumstances. It can be very damaging.
Maybe you're right. But we support each other. And that's all that matters.
You could both get fired.
You do realize you could both get fired. Hospital staff are not meant to have intimate relationships with one another.
Come on, Dr. Reed. Do you know how many rules are broken in this hospital every day just to keep it running? There's nothing wrong with what we're doing.
Fine. No, it's Trace.
I'd like to see...
Wise choice, Dr. Reed.
How do I have to sell? Oh. Well, never mind. Can't get to you yet.
Good evening, nurse.
Good.
And I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed.
I haven't met her yet.
Dr. Swansea has recently offered me a position in this hospital.
Well, it's a euphemism that your help will be appreciated, Doctor.
How would you describe the situation at the Pembroke Hospital?
It's serious. The flu is wreaking havoc amongst the staff and patients.
Yeah.
We are running out of everything.
Get a grip.
You must get a hold of yourself, nurse.
Sorry. I'm exhausted. No one has any idea when this epidemic will be over.
It won't last
nurse
forever.
Hawkins, the Spanish flu won't last forever. Even the Black Plague didn't kill everyone.
I wish I could believe you. But what if this epidemic was worse? What if in the end... nobody was spared.
Ooh. Okay, you've been a nurse for how long?
How long have you been a nurse?
Well, long enough to see that the epidemic is winning. And no matter how qualified you are, don't tell me you'll change that.
You'd be surprised what dedication can achieve, Nurse Hawkins.
Yes.
In medicine, sometimes we're just a test result away from a miracle.
Sorry, Doctor. I don't want to sound bitter, but I'm just too tired to give a pep talk like Nurse Branigan.
Okay, how's this half doping?
How is the Pembroke staff coping with the epidemic?
Well, not well. Milton, the ambulance driver, is even more grumpy than usual, especially concerning doctors.
Why is he so grumpy?
Why is Milton grumpy on a daily basis? Is it just an act?
Milton's not the kind of man who's bothered about a bad reputation. Whether he deserved it or not.
Oh.
Why does Milton dislike doctors?
I don't know. Just ask him. But be warned, Milton is not the chatty type.
Okay.
Pepper, I know you're very close to Milton Hooks.
Yes. Milton Hooks is my man. If you want to report me for that, just feel free, Doctor.
I have no intention of reporting you, Nurse Hawkins. But are you aware of the risks?
The rules say I won't be allowed to work as a nurse anymore. But here at the Pembroke, we break rules all the time.
Is he worth the risk?
Hey, I'm no perfect woman, and Milton is not the finest bloke. But we do our best to get by. That's all any of us can hope for nowadays.
All right. Personal question. Nothing. Bye.
Goodbye.
Oh wait, the patient's room.
Come now, we can handle this.
Oh.
Finally, you've returned, Doctor. Did you find anything of value?
Yes, nurse.
You've worked your first miracle, Doctor. Now, this patient here needs immediate treatment.
Duty calls? When the storm has passed, I'll show you how to mix the remedy yourself with the same basic ingredients.
Many thanks, Doctor. When you've finished, you ought to report to Dr. Swansea in his office. He's been looking for you. Seemed pressing.
Rat in the hospital.
Good evening, Mr. Goswick. How are you?
I'm okay.
Do you need any help?
I'm afraid I may, sir. I don't mean to be a burden.
Get medicine.
You are not a burden, sir. Healing you is my responsibility.
And yeah. You have my gratitude for that.
Why did your mother have you hospitalized here? She seems convinced this is a bad hospital.
My mother just wants the best for me. She won't rest while I'm here. She'd go all the way to hell and back to help me.
You're in good hands.
Pembroke Hospital may look unorthodox, but rest assured, you're in good hands here.
It's not me you have to convince, Dr. Reed. It's my mother.
Is your mother bothering you? As your doctor, I can ask her to leave you alone if you would prefer.
That's tempting, Doctor. But you have no idea what my mother is capable of. She would tie herself to my bed if you asked her to leave.
Do you need any help?
Thank you, Dr. Reed, but you've done enough already.
I have to go now, sir.
Okay, what's next?
Doctor.
Oh, I gotta talk to Swansea. Yeah, that's cool. I haven't tried it out yet either. So maybe if there's time later today, we could do that. Or maybe this weekend, Rob. But I am going to... Actually, I'm going to go spend my points and save the game there. We'll call it here. I have a way out. Oh, not yet. Tactical, no, potential. Oh, yes, I need that. Oh, you're a thousand. What about you? Oh, level 8. Okay. Yeah. There we go. Oh. The more lives you take, the unhealthier our district becomes. The district tells us. Oh. Oh, I still have to find him? Wait. Treatment pathology. Where did that pop up from? I do need to find him. It's gonna bug me. I need to open him. There yet. Okay. Oh, I can't do this. But yeah, let's upgrade them. Legend. So 58 and 75. Alright. How do I save? Rob, do you remember how to save on this? Because I don't. Because it's not this one. Is it autosave? Alright. I guess we're just gonna go with that. And with that... Wait, where's my phone? I feel like a raid today. Yep. You know who I'm raiding. Yes. Thank you all for being here. I'm gonna stick with this for a bit because I'm having to run back and forth. It's very fun. I'm into this. Just remember, when I start talking to people and going through their dialogue that I've already been through, I will skip. Okay, so I guess I'm not reading. See you guys!